the way up to 100%.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem.
You want, you can take my seat right here for a minute.
Oh, no, you guys stay seated.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I want to see if my, startup checklist lines up with yours. So, if the ground power unit's connected, I would turn on battery 1 and 2, followed by the external power. 3 8-ish to nav, corrosive supply on, and then I turn on the APU, wait 5 seconds, turn that on. Wait while it's on. Armed, smoking, seat belts, I turn on the nav and logo lights, and then I adjust the cabin, maybe 22 degrees Celsius. Is that about it?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
It's pretty good.
How'd you learn all that?
Microsoft Flight Simulator and a bunch of videos, yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome, man.
Yeah. Where's the switch to test the GPWS sounds, all the warning sounds? There's a way to test them all.
I think it's a test
light to see all of the lights on.
Yeah, you can test the lights.
No, not the lights. It's
we don't have
the sounds.
We don't have a test for the sounds.
Oh, seriously?
Is it like this?
No,
those are the flight attendants.
Oh, they're flight attendants. I thought it was the ground crew.
Ground crew's right here, so we can call maintenance with. Or ground crew with this mechanic button right here.
All right,
here.
That's what the crank is for down there, right? It's usually used for during maintenance.
Maintenance or like a startup procedure where we need to crank the engine to just get an airflow going through. Basically,
Where'd you guys learn? Cause I'm looking forward to flying the 321.
I went to school at Purdue University in Indiana.
Oh, I haven't seen a lot of ads about that.
Yeah, they've got a flight program, but it's. It's expensive. I don't know if it's worth it.
Okay.
He's filming.
Yeah. What would be the CSTR for? Because I turn it on for no apparent reason. I have no idea what it's for.
Constraints. So when we fly, like an arrival, and there's constraints on the arrival, like we have to cross this point, Morocco, between 24,000 and 27,000 feet. When we have constraints selected, that shows up on there, and you can change, like, you can see all the waypoints, you can see VORs, NDVs, which there really aren't any, and then airports is the other one.
Oh, all right.
On there.
Mind if I see the flight number?
Yeah.
I believe it's in INITS, right?
Yep.
Initiative. Oh, this is Initiative. Okay, this is 3, and then...
Hey, how you doing?
MCDU?
So, on the forward...
Wait, how would I see the aircraft type?
The tail number?
The aircraft type.
Type is going to be data, aircraft status. These are the engine types we have here in A321.
Alright, let me go down there and take a look at it.
What's the runway for departure?
We haven't been assigned one, but it's either going to be 22 left or 28 right from November 5.
Alright, thank you.
Yeah. Good luck.
Thank you.
flight attendants.